Dear students, in this video we'll discuss about class 8, Oxford New Learners Grammar and Composition, chapter number 17, the sentences, okay? So if you have not watched the previous chapters, so here look at the screen, you can go to the playlist section and also watch, okay? So here in this video we'll discuss about only page number 159, right? So here, identify the following sentences as simple, compound or complex. Also mark the coordinate and also subordinate clauses, right? So how to identify a simple sentence, a compound sentence and also a complex sentence, right? So you know in a simple sentence, okay, there is only one finite verb, right? So you know simple sentence means one main clause having one finite verb, right? So if there is only one finite verb, then we can say that it is a simple sentence. So you know if there is main clause plus coordinate clause, coordinate you know coordinating clause, if the clause consists with you know coordinating conjunction, right? So what are coordinating conjunction? So here look at the screen, so these are you know coordinating conjunctions, right? So first you know coordinators and, but, still, yet, or, for, otherwise, so, therefore, nevertheless, however, as well as, moreover, whereas. So these conjunctions you know called as coordinator conjunctions, right? Then you know correlatives, either or, neither nor, not only but also. So these conjunctions you know called as coordinating conjunction. So if there is a coordinating conjunction, then we can say that this is a yes coordinating clause. So if there is a coordinating clause, yes, so this sentence will be called as a compound sentence, right? Clear? So here look at the screen. Jaya and Anjali took the bus. So you know here yes and Anjali took the bus. So you know this is a first you have to identify whether this is a simple, compound or complex. So this is you know compound sentence, right? This is a compound sentence. So how do you know that this is a compound sentence, right? So you know there are two different subject, Jaya and Anjali. And here you know there is a conjunction and is which types of conjunction? Yes, this is you know coordinating conjunction, right? So if there is a coordinating conjunction, so this will be called as a compound sentence. Clear? The easiest way to identify the compound sentence, okay, so if there is you know coordinating conjunction, so as we have discussed about the coordinating conjunctions, okay, just you have to remember what are the coordinating conjunction, then you can easily identify which one is a compound sentence, right? So here, so you know Jaya and Anjali took the bus, this is you know compound sentence. And yes, so you know and Anjali took the bus, this is you know a coordinate clause. So you know here, yes, and you know coordinating conjunction. Coordinating conjunction plus yes clause, you know this is called as a coordinating clause. So you know clause here is yes, Anjali took the bus, this is a clause. As there is a subject Anjali, there is a verb took, right? So here the first one, this is you know compound sentence, and here and Anjali took the bus, this is you know coordinating clause, right? Then next question here, eat the chapatis or take some rice. So you know yes, so you know this is a compound sentence, right? This is a compound sentence. So how do you identify this is a compound sentence? Yes, as you know there is a conjunction. Which conjunction? So you know there is coordinating conjunction, right? So here first you have to mention this is a compound sentence and or take some rice, so you know this is a coordinating clause, right? So here the answer, okay, the first you have to mention this is a compound sentence and here or take some rice, this is you know coordinate clause. Clear? So as you know there is a coordinating conjunction or is used. So as you know fan boys, yes, so you know F stands for, A stands for and, N stands for nor, B stands for but, O stands for or, Y stands for yet, S stands for so. The easiest way, this is one acronym, okay? Then next question here. I told you study, yet you didn't listen. First, you know, this is a compound sentence. So how, yes, so how you identify this is a compound sentence? Because there is a coordinating conjunction, yet is used, right? So here yet, you know, this is a coordinating conjunction, so this is, you know, compound sentence, so, right? So you know there are two clauses, I told you to study and another clause, you know, you didn't listen. And you know there is a coordinating conjunction, yet is used, right? So here, you know, yet you didn't study, this is, you know, coordinating clause. Right? So first you have to mention this is a compound sentence, and yet you didn't listen, you know, this is a coordinate clause. Clear? Then next question here. Akash was waiting at the bus stop. So as I have already discussed, you know, if there is only one finite verb, you know, was, you know, that this is only one finite verb, so this is, you know, simple sentence. Look at the previous examples here, you can find here. Okay, so Jaya took the bus, right? Anjali took the bus. So you know, this is a simple sentence, this is a simple sentence. As in the first sentence, you find Jaya took, there is only one finite verb. In the second sentence, Anjali took. So here took, there is only one finite verb. But when we combine these two sentences, we find a compound sentence, not a simple sentence, right? So here, just combine the sentence here. So you know, here two sentences are combined here. Jaya and Anjali took the bus, right? So here you have to mention, right? Jaya and Anjali took the bus. Clear? So this is a compound sentence because there is, you know, coordinating conjunction and is used, and here two different subject. That means, sir, two sentences are joined. Like Jaya took the bus, Anjali took the bus. We have to combine the sentence Jaya and Anjali took the bus. So as there is only one finite verb, but this will be considered as a compound sentence. Why? Now because there is a coordinating conjunction is used, and here two different subjects. Right? Clear? So in the second sentence there are two verb, eat, take, two finite verb. In the third sentence, told, didn't listen, so you know there are two verb. But in the fourth sentence, was, right, there is only one finite verb, so this will be called as a simple sentence. Clear? So if there is only one finite verb, this will be called as simple sentence. Right? Then next question here, as I was late, I didn't see Raj at the party. Here, as you know, there is, yes, as you know, here this is a subordinating conjunction. So if there is subordinating conjunction, then it will be called as a complex sentence. If there is a coordinating conjunction, then this will be called as a compound sentence. Clear? So here, look at the screen. You can take a complete note of it. Okay? So what are the subordinating conjunctions? So here, look at the screen. So you know, there are three types of subordinating conjunction. First, you know, simple subordinators, then compound subordinators, then correlative subordinators. So first, you know, simple subordinators. Just you have to remember, okay, these subordinating conjunctions. So first, you know, simple subordinators. So you know, after, before, since, when, though, although, unless, where, as, because, if, why, till, until. Then you know, compound subordinators. You know, as plus adjective as, that means as fast as, okay, as quick as. Then next, not so plus adjective plus as, then as soon as, in case, as though, even though, as if, so that, in order that, provided that. So these, you know, these all are known as subordinating conjunctions. Then last one, correlative subordinators. So you know, no sooner than, so that, scarcely when, such that, hardly when, whether or, right? So you have to just remember all these subordinating conjunction, because these conjunction will help you to identify the complex sentence, right? So if these subordinating conjunctions are there, then the sentence will be called as, this is, you know, yes, subordinating clause, or you know, this is called as, yes, complex sentence. So as you know here, as, yes, so you know, as, this is a subordinating conjunction, right? So this will be called as a complex sentence. Clear? Complex sentence. So as I was late, this is, you know, subordinating clause, right? And you know, I didn't see Raj at the party, this is a main clause, independent clause, principal clause, right? So here you have to write here, as I was late. So first, as I was late, so you know, this is a complex sentence, right? As I was late, this is, you know, subordinate clause. Why? Now because, you know, there is a subordinating conjunction as is used, right? Then next question here. Alia wasn't going, so I decided not to go either, right? So you know, so, yes, so, you know, this is a coordinating conjunction, so this is a compound sentence, right? Alia wasn't going, so I decided not to go either. Right? So here. So first you have to mention this is a compound sentence. So I decided not to go either. This is a coordinate clause, not a subordinating, because you know there is a coordinating conjunction so, and the clause will be called as a coordinating clause, not a subordinating clause. Right? Then next question here. Unless you try something, you can't know if you like it or not. So you know unless, right? So unless you know this is a subordinating conjunction and there is a clause, you try something. So this is, you know, yes, subordinating clause. So this is a complex sentence, right? Complex sentence. The first you have to mention complex sentence and then you have to write, okay, subordinate clause. So here, you know this is, yes, this is, you know, complex sentence. Right? And unless you try something, this is, you know, subordinate clause. Why? Now because there is a subordinating conjunction unless. Clear? Then next question here. I searched for the book at the library. Right? So you know there is only one finite verb, searched. So this is a simple sentence. Clear? So as you know there are two different subject, Anjali and Jaya, and there is a coordinating conjunction and. So this is a compound sentence, and you know and Anjali took the bus, this is a coordinating clause, right? Then in the second one there are two finite verbs, eat and you know take, and there is a conjunction, coordinating conjunction or is used. So this is a compound sentence, and here or take some rice, this is a coordinating clause, right? Then in the third one, I told you to study. So here told and you and didn't, you know, this is, there are two finite verb, right? And there is, you know, coordinating conjunction yet is used. So this is a compound sentence, and yet you didn't listen. So this is, you know, coordinate clause. Then next, Akash was sitting at the bus stop. So you know, was sitting, yes, to was. This is, you know, there is only one finite verb. So this is a simple sentence. Then as I was late, so you know, as, this is a subordinating conjunction, right? And you know, this is a, yes, so this is a complex sentence. As there are two finite verb, was and did, right? So this is a complex. Then next, Alia was not going, so I decided. So you know here coordinating conjunction so is used. So this is a compound sentence, and so I decided not to go either. This is a coordinating clause. Then unless you try something, so you know unless, this is a subordinating conjunction. So this is a complex sentence, and unless you try something, this is, you know, subordinating clause. Then last one, I searched for the book at the library. So you know there is only one finite verb, sought. So this is a simple sentence. Clear? Then next here, read the following passage and identify the different types of sentences in it, right? So here, on the first day of school, Riya met her best friend Priya. So you know this is a declarative sentence, okay? Then next, the name of their class teacher was Mrs. Das. So this is also declarative. She was so nice and kind. So you know there is an exclamation mark is used. So this is an exclamatory sentence. Okay. Then next, she first told them about the rules to be followed in her class before roll call. So this is a declarative sentence. After that, she asked them whether they had any questions. So this is also declarative sentence. She asked questions in the class. This is also declarative sentence. What would you like to learn today? So, you know, this is a double edged question. That means, yes, interrogative sentence. Interrogative, you know, two types. Double edged question and yes, no question. So, here the sentence starts with double edged word. So, this is a double edged question or interrogative sentence. Are you excited about your new classes? Your new class? So, you know, here this is yes, no. You know, this is yes, no question. That means interrogative, right? What is your favorite subject? So, as you know, yes, this is here WH word is used, and at the end here question mark is used. So this is an interrogative sentence, right? Then next, you like to play with your friends, don't you? So you know this is also interrogative. As you know, here question tag is used. Okay, so this is interrogative, right? Not declarative sentence. What do you like to play? So here WH word and question mark. So this is an interrogative sentence. While answering these questions, students became very comfortable with each other. Okay. So here each other. So this is, you know, declarative. Okay. So you have to mention here declarative. right? The next year, Riya and Priya also answered the sum of four, okay, questions. So, you know, this is declarative sentence. After this, she asked the students to read the first chapter. This is also declarative. Guess what it was about? As you know here, yes, question mark is used and WH word. So, this is an interrogative. It was about Tom Sawyer. So, you know, yes, so as you know, their exclamation sign is used. So, this is an exclamative sentence. Riya had read the book before, but Priya hadn't. This is declarative. Okay. So, Riya told her all about the book. This is also declarative. After getting to know about the story, Priya became very interested in reading the chapter. This is also declarative. By the time they had finished reading two paragraphs, the bell rang. So, this is also declarative. They rushed to the playground to play with their friends. This is also declarative. It seems that, they really enjoyed their first day of the news. Of the new class. As you know, there is an exclamation sign is used, so this is an exclamatory sentence, right? Clear? So I think this video will help you. If you find any doubt, okay, so you can comment in the comment box. Thank you.